Welcome back to the channel. Let's get going. Again, these are just too easy to fake to even be up for consideration as to whether or not they're real. There could be someone sitting in that cabinet below that drawer that's moving it in and out. Again, the drawer only came out on its own, so it could be a string tied to it. Let me just stop right here and say really, really, really quickly, if you're enjoying this content, I make another video just like this one every single day. And if you click that subscribe button, you can come back and join me tomorrow.
They said a man was attacked by a bear. Dang. Y'all know what that means, right? When he got attacked by that bear, I think that was his supper.
I think I've seen this before. They're claiming it's a bear attack, and I think it was actually found to be a hoax, and I could be completely wrong here, but I believe this was found to be a hoax, and that was actually a vehicle from a film set. This just reminded me of where my wife used to work. She is a nurse and she used to work for a mental health prison. And this looks to be exactly like the way she described the facilities there, even down to the sounds. So not so much creepy as a little unsettling. I'm gonna make one of these and I'm gonna show y'all how easy it is to make. Just within the week, I'll have it up. Those dogs weren't really scared. This was all a setup. That scream was just some audio recording that played and startled the dogs awake. The guy was waiting for it. He jumps up, starts herding the dogs into another room. Their tails are wagging. They think it's playtime. They know there's no real threat. This reminds me of, and I believe this is what's going on, but this reminds me of what's called ghosting. It looks like the frame rate is so low to allow enough light into the lens on this camera to even get an image that anything moving in the image just becomes blurry. A good example, in the old days, they had to let a lot of light into these small sensor cameras, so you had to sit very, very still while they flashed that huge bulb. And if you moved at all, the image would be blurry.
What was that? Oh my God. Did you see that?
Something's behind the garage.
Oh.
Uh-oh, you're gonna see the
trap,
girl. We're real scared of them. Ran!
Stay here, ref. You stay here.
Oh my God. Oh my God. We better get back inside.
This is an old video. I've seen this before, years ago, actually. Even then, I didn't think this was Bigfoot. If you look at the silhouette of this guy, it looks like someone who's wearing really thick hunting clothes or just really thick outdoor gear, and they just look bulky, and that makes them look give more the appearance of an animal instead of a man. But yeah, I think that's all it is. I think it's some creep sneaking about out in the woods and looking at their house, and he got spotted, and the dog come out there barking, and now he's trying to get away before he's caught. I believe I'd be keeping my windows rolled up from now on. Someone on one side of the door, or more likely, they've got something tied on, that's like an L-shaped handle, so it comes out. They got something tied onto the bottom, on the end of it, so that they can just sit there and pull a string or something. That's probably what's happening. And then someone's laying down on the floor with their arm up in that bedside table, moving that drawer back and forth. Come on, people, give me something difficult.
Copy me. Touch my hand. Coming. That is ice cold.
Okay. I'm not going to jump straight to conclusions and say this is fake. Can tell you how it could be faked. So how it could be faked is you simply record both shots. One of you reaching your hand out as the guy, one of you pretending to be the ghost. Then you put a blank background image on the side of the screen where the ghost is supposed to be, and then you rotoscope out just the pink, just the lines, and then you superimpose those lines over that blank background image. Now you have just the lines without the man behind it, over the same background, because it's a static camera, it's not moving. Voila. Not saying that's how it's done, but you could do that in 15 minutes. Surely that's not even meant to be taken seriously.
I don't know if I'm tripping, but I wonder who's that chilling in that island. He's so huge, this is crazy. And he's moving, what the flip? This is crazy, look at the distance. This is madness. Guys, who is that? Chilling at this dude.
I'm not convinced that there's even a person standing on that island. For one thing, the first person does look like a man standing there. The last two that he spots don't look like people at all. I'm not convinced that I saw the first guy move. I think if anything, it was just a ripple, like a visual ripple, because you're looking through such great distance over the water that give it the appearance of movement, but I'm not convinced that it moved. I don't think there's a person standing over there that's 200 foot tall. It's hard to have anything to say on that one because it's hard to really see what's going on. It looks like some sort of a cave with a giant or something coming in and out of it. But the black levels on the cave look a little darker than the black levels on the rest of the mountain. So if I had to guess, this is superimposed onto that cliff.
That is, until he starts to edit it back at the office and sees this. Watch closely. As the face of a young child appears inside the wrecked car, Loudney is stunned. Not only me.
If anybody has any more information about this, please hit me up in the comments and let me know. Because this looks like the most convincing piece of ghost footage I've ever seen. That does not look like a ghost, and they're reporting this on the news. If this is legit, we might have found something here. Please, somebody give me a name, a date, something that I can research. You can see at the beginning of the clip that the door's already open, because if it wasn't, then the string that they tie around the door handle to pull to open the door slowly wouldn't work, because the door would be latched still, and they can't get the string to pull hard enough because it's a thin string that can't be picked up on camera. So if they pull too hard, it's going to break. They can't pull hard enough to open the door. So it has to be ajar. It has to be open already. It doesn't look creepy. If anything, it doesn't look creepy. It just looks like a coyote or something with the baby deer in its mouth walking off with its meal for the night. And with that, and it being Thanksgiving, I'm gonna go have me a meal. So I appreciate you guys coming and hanging out with me tonight. I will be back tomorrow with another video, and I will see you then. See you tomorrow.